All right, so Dallas Smith, basically one of the biggest stars in the country right now, is buddies with everybody from, you know, in Florida Georgia Line, and he hangs out with, you know, the A-listers, and he goes on tour with, you know, everybody, and he decides to sign you
somehow, some
to
way,
his record label, Shawn Austin. I'm trying to, I'm just, tell, take me through how it happened, but also what it feels like right now to be kind of at the crest of what's going. I mean, maybe not at the crest yet, you're getting towards that, but this is a big time for you.
It's unbelievable. Yeah. For to do this kind of, be involved in this kind of tour this early on, is unreal. I mean, the story, the long story short of the story about how I came.
No, don't make it short. You can tell us the whole story.
So yeah, I was, I mean, I've been playing in Vancouver for about 12 years, just doing the restaurant, the pub and bar scene and all that. And we're going back about 3 years. I ended up meeting a guy who's been a buddy of mine for a long time, or since then, and we worked independently together, put out a track. We're working a lot of music, and he knew Dallas from the Default days. He used to tour, he did Warped Tour, and I told him, I said, I know you know Dallas, but I don't want him knowing anything about me as a musician. I'd love to know the guy, because I've been a fan of Dallas since I was like 12.
Okay.
So I'd much rather him just, you know, get to know him.
Is a dude, this is a buddy of a buddy.
Buddy of a buddy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just, let's I want to know this guy and talk about hockey and just, you know, let's keep the music out of it. So he didn't listen to anything I said, and as we kind of kept putting music out, Dallas got it all, and eventually, I guess Dallas liked what he heard, and a couple weeks later, got a call and said he wanted to sit down and chat a little bit, and we've been working together since then, and signed shortly after.
Okay, so that's incredible. So this is like the beginning of something massive. But your backstory is, you said you did the pub scene and the bar scene.
Yep.
You and a guitar.
Me and a guitar.
You and a guitar doing covers?
250 shows a year, covers, originals.
250 shows a year?
Yeah.
So this is the main gig?
No.
No, you were also working a regular job?
Yeah, 9 to 5s.
Really?
Yeah.
And still doing 250 shows a year?
You got it.
That's absolutely incredible. What kind of stuff were you playing in the bars? Anything, everything?
I mean, a lot of country. In Vancouver, it took a while, like in the earlier, like in, you know, 10 years back.
Yeah.
To kind of fit that in. A lot of John Mayer, a lot of Maroon 5 stuff, you know,
just
kind of a big range of stuff, so everyone in the room could kind of relate and hear something that they liked.
But you would get residencies, so you'd be like the guy who was in there at the same place every Friday night kind of deal. The owners dug you because you made the people happy.
Yeah. I got a little bit of notoriety around just for being that guy.
Well, you know, Tim Hicks' kind of upbringing is not dissimilar, right?
Yeah. So we were kind of thinking that there's some parallels to that, and hopefully it can kind of continue to go the same direction.
But he's another one of those guys that did that many shows a year all the time. That was his thing, right?
I mean, but for me, I think I wouldn't change anything about it. My most comfortable place is behind a mic with a guitar in my hands.
Yeah.
So even though, you know, it seems like a lot and a lot of work, it's fun, right?
What was your hope when you were playing those bars? Did you hope that there would be somebody in the crowd one day? Did you hope that there would be somebody that kind of like said, hey, I like that thing that you did, you should come and open for me? Or like one of those, were you hoping that thing was going to happen?
You're always hoping for the aspirations that, you get that, you know, somebody comes in who knows somebody who's, you know, the found this guy doing this and doing that. And there was a lot of times when I kind of thought it was happening.
Is that right? Some stops and starts?
Quite a few.
Or starts and stops?
Yeah. And, but it's, again, I wouldn't have changed anything now because it just feels right. And having the time in the restaurants and pubs to kind of hone my craft and get comfortable doing it now.
Yeah. So you go from a stage like that to performing at some place, you know, that fits 5, 6, 7, 8,000 people.
That's a bit of a difference.
It's a bit of a different. Yeah. What was the hardest part about making that transition?
Well, not having a guitar in my hands now.
Yeah. So you're singing more.
It's just it's just kind of doing the Dallas thing. But I mean, I've got the safety net of Dallas beside me now, right?
Yeah.
So it's not as bad. But it's a whole different game. I mean, you can't, it's almost easier in some ways because you know that the crowd's there having a good time. They're there for music, and it's easy to, you know, when they're giving you the energy back, you can kind of kick it back out. But it's now playing with an incredible band and lights everywhere and cryo guns going off. It's just a lot to get used to.
Okay, so the family, were they always kind of supportive of the choice you'd made?
Yeah.
Did they always know that music was so much in your heart that you were going to follow this no matter what they said?
Well,
no matter how much they tried to talk you out of it?
We all thought it was baseball to start.
Oh, right, okay.
Baseball for 18 years.
You're another one of those guys.
Yeah.
Another one of those guys. Another one of those, you know, the Sam Hunts, the Brett Youngs, all of those guys, right?
I'm quite happy to be mixed in with that group.
Brian Kelly, all of these guys who, you know, who went on to, you know, who've gone on to incredible success. Chad Brownlee, right?
Yeah. So, you know, I had, there was a, you know, small chance, small time there when the pros were a possibility.
Yeah.
But through injuries and politics, kind of like everybody else, that ended. But the music was kind of always there in the background as well. And then that just took the forefront real quickly. And it was the passion that I truly loved as opposed to the one that faded.
Okay.
And
but there are things that you can take. And I know I've talked to all those guys that I mentioned before. Things that you take from the discipline that's instilled in you through athletics that you can transfer over into the music world, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, the dedication, the requirement to kind of work on your craft is all that. But for me, I think the biggest thing now working with these guys is the team aspect. It's working with a good group of guys that everyone kind of gets along. We all come
motivate each other.
I think we all come from similar cloth, and it just makes it that much easier, and the results are that much better.
So those days too of like playing all of those shows, those 250 shows a year. There's a sign inside here on one of the, I guess this is where the Oshawa Generals play, right?
Yeah,
behind
us
here, Tribute Communities Center in Oshawa, Ontario. There's a sign on the. One of the doors, the dressing room doors, that's a quote from Wayne Gretzky that says, "You miss 100% of the shots you don't take."
Mm-hmm.
So that's like, you don't get discovered, you don't get picked up by somebody like Dallas if you're just at home in your basement with a guitar or playing Xbox or and griping about the industry, right?
Yeah, you got to be out there. You got to be kind of fighting for the dream and the passion, and it's something for me that. Even though it's taken, you know, for some it's a long time, for some it's a short amount of time.
Yeah.
But the 12 years, it's just nice to get a chance now.
Yeah.
And take a real shot at it and see where we can go.
What's your flavor? What's your type of country?
There's a lot of different titles that I hear. You know, the modern country sound.
Modern country sound.
I love it. I love it. And it's kind
big
of
big anthemic, big choruses, sing along kind of stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. But just really strong melodies too.
Yeah.
I think that's important for people to kind of hook onto and obviously things that people can relate with.
Yeah.
Which is why, like with Paradise Found, the current single, it was one that we couldn't let go.
Yeah.
It was something that was going to be a perfect song that we all thought would kind of fit the mold, and it's something that I can relate with really closely. And I mean, I do a lot of writing on my own, but this one
came to you from somebody else.
Well, it came from Florida Georgia Line.
It did.
It was there. They've got a
Tyler and BK,
a publishing company called Tree Vibes Music.
Yes, they do.
And so this one, we got lucky enough to have this one come down our desk, and couldn't let it go.
You are keeping some good company.
I am. I'm very, very lucky for that.
Yeah. That's great. The stories that you like to tell, I mean, are you going, when you write yourself, are you an autobiographical guy?
It has to come from somewhere.
Because you've lived a life already, the 12 years kind of to get to here. You've lived a life already. There's some stories. There's got to be some stories in there.
There's always stories. And I'm sure people will notice as things go on that most of my stories are, you know, there's a girl involved.
Yeah.
So it's always,
same girl? Different girl?
Different girls. But
attaboy. But live a little.
Yeah.
Live a little.
But
you know, I was tired. Those guys, the Kissels of the world, who like marry their, you know, and they get the high school sweethearts and all.
Yeah.
It's great and everything, but the dream of, you know, if you want to get into the music business and the rock and roll world or whatever it's going to be, is to kind of like go out and, you know,
you gotta have
kind
some
of like live a little.
You got to, you know, you got to know what you like and find the right thing. And I, you know, it's kind of the Taylor Swift thing. You get songs out of it every time, either way. So. You know.
All right. So the plan, we've talked a little bit about the immediacy and what's going on right now.
Yep.
Coming up, you're working on an EP.
Yeah, EP's in the works. We got another single getting teed up for early in the new year.
Okay.
But right now, it's just getting the foundation strong. We're hoping to have a big 2018. We weren't expecting 2017 to kind of do what it's done so far.
Yeah.
And now being a part of this show is even more insane.
Yeah.
But things are looking good right now.
Good for you, man. Yeah. You know, they always say that you can't go to school to learn how to be a rock star. There's rock star school. You go up there on stage and kind of do your thing. But this is, you're in it.
You got to experience
you're
it.
You're actually in it. I'm wrong. I've been wrong about that the whole time. Dallas brings you into the family.
Yeah.
And you're kind of going to school right now a little bit.
Oh,
right?
You get thrown in the deep end right
away.
It's like sink or swim. And hopefully I'm swimming right now, but it feels good. It's like I said, it's just a great, an amazing opportunity for me to get this so early on.
And, yeah. Well, so early on, 12 years.
Well, yeah, fair enough.
Overnight success after 12 years. Yeah. This is great. Continued success.
Thank
Looking forward
much.
To following you, man.
I appreciate
Way
it.
Way to go.
Cheers.